Hello viewers, I welcome you all to this talk on derivation of Schrodinger time dependent wave equation. Objective of today's talk is to derive Schrodinger time dependent wave equation for matter waves of a moving particle. Learning outcomes would be that after learning this topic, learners will be able to explain the need of Schrodinger wave equation. They derive time-dependent wave equation by eliminating E in Schrodinger time-independent wave equation. Let me introduce the topic. Schrodinger wave equation is the basic equation of motion of matter waves. It describes the wave nature of a moving particle in mathematical form. Schrodinger wave equation is a partial differentiation equation. Schrodinger wave equation is a partial differential equation that describes the dynamics of quantum mechanical system using a wave function psi of x, y, z and time t. Schrodinger wave equation is a new type of wave equation that connects de Broglie wavelength with the classical wave equation for a moving particle. Its solution gives the trajectory, the position, momentum, and energy of the particle. There are two types of Schrodinger wave equation. One is time-independent Schrodinger wave equation, and the other is time-dependent Schrodinger wave equation. Already, we have learned how to derive time-independent Schrodinger wave equation. In today's class, let us discuss and derive time-dependent Schrodinger wave equation. In classical physics, there exist two entities. In the universe, things exist in two forms, particles and waves. Particles are localized bundles of energy and momentum with a mass m. Waves are disturbances that spread over the space and travel over time. Matter waves can be described by a wave function psi of x, y, z and time t. Consider a particle of mass m moving with velocity v. Here is the particle and this particle is going to travel along x-axis. We know a moving particle is always associated with matter waves. Where is the amplitude of the wave is maximum? Probably we can find the particle there. Let psi is a variable quantity associated with this moving particle. Psi is a complex function of space coordinates of the particle and time t. Psi should be finite, single value and continuous. And also, it should be a periodic function. The function psi is called wave function as it characterizes the de Broglie waves associated with a moving particle. The differential equation representing a one-dimensional wave motion is given by dou squared psi by dou t squared, which is equal to v squared del squared psi, where v is the velocity of the particle. Psi is a wave function depending on the space coordinates x, y, z and time t. In this wave function, let us separate the space coordinates x, y, z and time t in this way. Psi of x, y, z t can be written as psi of x, y, z into e power minus I omega t. Let us now find the general solution for this equation. Let us consider psi equal to sine of e power minus I omega t, where psi naught is a constant. Now let us differentiate this equation with respect to time. So dou psi by dou t equal to psi naught is a constant. Let us write like that. Differentiate e power minus I omega t with respect to time. So when we differentiate, we find minus I omega into e power minus I omega t. We all of us know omega is angular frequency, which is equal to 2 pi nu. So substitute omega in this expression, we get dou psi by dou t is equal to psi naught. Now substitute for omega, minus I 2 pi nu into e power minus I omega t, which is equal to, now separate it, minus 2 pi I nu is constant we have taken outside. You write psi naught into e power minus I omega t. We know psi naught e power minus I omega t is psi, the solution of the equation. So this first order differential equation becomes minus 2 pi I nu psi. So dou psi by dou t is equal to minus 2 pi I. We know nu equal to e pi h. This is from Planck's law. So substituting for nu, we are getting the expression as minus 2 pi I e by h psi. Dou psi by dou t is equal to minus e dou psi by dou t is equal to minus I e by h cross psi, because we know h by 2 pi is h cross. Now let us take the right hand side to the left hand side. You get e psi equal to, you just cross multiply and you get I h cross dou psi by dou t. Just we have rearranged. So when you write e psi equal to, you will be getting h cross dou psi by dou t by I. You multiply and divide by I, you will be getting I h cross, denominator we have I squared, that I squared is equal to minus 1. So minus into minus 1 becomes plus. So e psi equal to I h cross dou psi by dou t. Now substituting the value e psi in Schrodinger time independent wave equation, we get del squared psi plus 2m h cross squared of I h cross dou psi by dou t minus v psi equal to 0. So del squared psi, you take this to the right hand side, you are getting minus 2m by h cross squared of I h cross dou psi by dou t minus v psi. Just multiply throughout by minus h cross squared by 2m. We get del squared psi. Rearrange this equation. You are getting del squared psi equal to minus 2m by h cross squared of I h cross dou psi by dou t minus v psi. Now multiply throughout this equation by minus h cross squared by 2m. You will be getting minus h cross squared by 2m del squared psi equal to I h cross dou psi by dou t minus v psi. Minus h cross squared by 2m del squared psi. Bring this v psi to the left hand side. So you are getting plus v psi, which is equal to I h cross dou psi by dou t. This equation is known as Schrodinger time dependent wave equation. You can see the time factor dou by dou t is here. So this equation is called Schrodinger time dependent wave equation. In three dimensional space, it can be written as minus h cross squared by 2m del squared psi of xyz t plus v psi of xyz t, which is equal to I h cross dou by dou t of psi of xyz t. The equation 4 also can be written as, you just take the wave function outside the bracket, you are getting minus h cross squared by 2m del squared plus v. So outside the bracket you write psi, which is equal to I h cross dou by dou t of psi. This can be written as h operator psi, which is equal to e operator psi, where h operator is given by minus h cross squared by 2m del squared plus v, and e operator is given by I h cross dou by dou t. Equation 5 describes the motion of non-relativistic material particle. I hope you have understood how to derive Schrodinger time dependent wave equation. It's a very simple derivation. I hope you have understood. Thank you all.